right from the beginning, I took out, I just ignored the fact that he was a vampire, basically ignored the fact that he was 108, except to use some kind of metaphorical purposes. And you're just left with a kind of troubled teenager who, and it's a really simple story of him getting content with himself. I mean, and he gets content by finding a woman and then having a child, which is like, I guess, how a lot of kind of troubled guys kind of balance themselves out. At least that's the hope, anyway.
Well, Bill Condon mentioned this idea of the self-loathing that you told him you'd been playing for the first three movies, that had never really been presented as a element, you know, in the actual, I guess, plot of the first three films.
Yeah, I mean, I thought that would be the key ingredient to Edward's character. I mean, he's a 108-year-old guy who's never achieved anything he's wanted to achieve. I mean, he's been stuck in adolescence. I mean, when you're an adolescent, you think you think nothing is given to you. I mean, you think everything's unfair, blah, 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 and he's been living like that for 100 years. So, I mean, it's, you know, you'd eventually get to the point of desperation. And I guess it wasn't. I mean, it's very difficult to portray that and portray a love story at the same time, unless you want to make a very different movie. I mean, and so I was trying to push for that angle at the same time, but... And it's funny, but Bill was the first person to say, like, I want to put this at the forefront, because Breaking Dawn is probably the happiest Edward's been in the whole series. So it's like, it's the wrong moment to use that. But we did a couple of flashback scenes and stuff like that, which kind of reflect his anger, I guess, when he first turned into a vampire.
And then for your own personal journey these past 4 years with what this role's done with you?
I guess just presented, like, I mean, a whole variety of obstacles in terms of trying to grow and figure out who you want to be. I mean, it's, you know, it's like having a very complicated maze to go through, and you're also being propelled by some kind of jet as well, and trying to figure out how to go through a maze at the same time. And I still kind of feel like it hasn't really slowed down. I'm still trying to figure out where I'm at. But it's been fun, and you kind of, you know, it's totally bizarre to me. I mean, I I've said it for years now, I didn't even know if I was going to continue acting before this happened, and now I have much more of a drive and passion for it than I ever did before. So.
Rob, the music is so important to these movies. What's on your iPod right now? Any particular songs on your playlist?
I always sound so pretentious on it.
Please do get pretentious.
Oh, but I hope I can remember some people on that. There's this band called Pato, like this 70s band, which I really like, and a pianist called Armin Jamal.
I'm going to have to look those up because I don't know how to spell it.
That's so stupid. Okay,
Rob, can you talk a little bit about your last moments of... Over here. Hi. Could you talk a little bit about your last moments of ever playing Edward? We heard it was in the woods, and then Christian made a great joke, and also about the scene where you finally turn her.
She made a great joke in the woods.
She ran off.
She's done that throughout the whole scene. Sorry, what was the second part of the question?
And the second part about turning her and that scene with the baby being born.
The scene, the birth scene. I mean, I read the script before I read the book on this, and it was the first time I'd done that, and. And so I read that scene, being kind of astonished that, I mean, I knew it was kind of crazy, the story, but I couldn't really believe that it was actually written down and we were going to do it, and it was terrifying going into it. But it ended up being this kind of, I don't know, it was one of the most incredible scenes to do in this movie. I mean, there's definitely a kind of R-rated... or maybe NC-17 rated version of of a few scenes in this movie. But it was just incredible to do that. Like, after having, because of the violence and stuff in it, it gave you a lot of freedom in the scene. And having every character so desperate, it became something very, very different. I mean, especially for Edward, who's always held back and is a pacifist, and he's very objective and logical about everything. To do this thing when you're suddenly playing Edward, stuck between a kind of emaciated dummy's legs chewing through a placenta and getting cream cheese all over your face, and strawberry jam, and then pulling out a three-week-old baby after with a wig on. It's like something out of Bing Wong movie or something.